writer declared the same thing. He spoke and he talks about how God had laid the foundations of the world. And how God had laid the foundations of the world and how they remain. You know, the Bible tells us in the word of the Lord, it's very clear in Ephesians 3, I believe it's verses 21, the Bible says that we live in a world without end. You hear some preachers stand up and talk about the end of the world. That ain't in the Bible. Jesus never taught the end of the world. Come on, somebody. Matter of fact, Revelation 21, God's going to come back and there's going to be a new heaven and a new earth. Come on. Hallelujah. Here you go, Al Gore, if you're watching in the future. Here's your global warming message. Hallelujah. You can find it in the Word of God in 2 Peter 3, verses 10. God said the earth that we know it as is going to pass away with a loud, great noise. A fervent heat's going to burn up all the elements and the works therein. How God's going to purge this earth as we know it. Praise the Lord God with fire. He did it in Noah's day with water, but he'll never do it again that way. The next time will be with fire. Glory to God. But he never said the earth was going to pass away. Now the world as we know it will be changed. The world as we know it will be the same. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Praise God. So anytime anybody gets up and starts talking about the end of the world, the end of the world, shut them off and shut them down and get away from them. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. So this world is going to remain forever. It's going to last forever. But I want you to hear, amen, the Hebrew writer, amen, in Hebrews 1 is quoting from Psalms 102, what David declared. And he talks about how God laid the foundations of the earth and the world and how it remains forever. Then he talks about how it shall perish one day as a garment wastes away. Glory to God. Like a garment wears out. Praise God. The world is, as we know it, one day is just going to get two more out. Praise God. It's going to wear down. But then he makes reference to God and said to God, you remain forever. Glory to God. Psalms chapter 90 in verses 1 said in the word of God, before the foundations of the world were brought forth and before the mountains were created, thou, O God, are from everlasting to everlasting. Come on. The Bible said in Isaiah 57 and 15, he inhabits eternity. God is so massive. He is so big. He is so huge. Time can't even expose all he is. Time can't even reveal all he has. Glory to God. He's so big. The only place that can reveal him is forever. Come on, somebody. Somebody, we sing it tonight. Amen. Forever, he is faithful. Forever, hallelujah, God is true. Somebody say forever. Friend, I want you to know before time began, he was. And when time will be no more, he will be. Come on, somebody. He is him who was, who is, and is to come. Glory to God. Revelation 1 and verses 8. And behold, hear the words of the Lord tonight. God wants you to know, throughout all the time, he said, I've been the same since the beginning, and I won't change. Malachi 3 and 6, he said, I'm the Lord, and I change not. Therefore, you sons of Jacob shall not be consumed. Throughout all the time, he said, I'll change not. He said, and that's why you're not consumed. Times change, people change. But God says, I stay the same. Years come and go. But Psalms 102, 27 says, my years, hallelujah, have no end. Hebrews 1 and 12 says, thou art the same in your ear. You're not your ears, I hope yours don't. But your years do not fail. Praise God. His years do not fail. Psalms 102, 27 says, your years do not end. Yeah. Hallelujah. Somebody asked one time, well, when was Jesus' birthday? I said, forever.
Amen. That's fine.
What'd you just say? I said, forever. I said, because his birthday was not when he was born of a virgin, conceived of the Holy Ghost. He told the Pharisees, that's why they wanted to kill him. He said, before Abraham was, I am.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
I was in a Sunday school class years ago. And the teacher was trying to teach everybody that Jesus' divinity did not come about until he was born from that virgin womb. That Jesus His divinity, His sovereignty, amen, as Lord and Savior began at that moment. Hello. Now, I got a holy nosiness, but I got a holy boldness too. Come on, somebody. And I was sitting there just waiting for an opportunity, and so He opened up the floor. Come on, somebody. And I promise you, when I got through, I closed it. Hello? Hallelujah. Because He was even teaching this garbage. He was teaching from Genesis 1:26 when God said, let us make man after our own image. He was trying to say that God was, and this was in the Pentecostal church now, He was trying to say that that was Lucifer. I thought, I want to pull a Fred Sanford out, but I hit myself back. I thought, I want to say you big. My Lord, how in the world? Satan ain't creative. He ain't never created a thing. He's a destroyer. 1 Corinthians 10:10 calls Him that. Somebody say a destroyer. The devil ain't creator. Let us. I said, bro, what you gonna do with John chapter 1? God said concerning Jesus, there's not a thing that's made that is made without it. I said, what you gonna do with Colossians 1:17? By Him all things consist. That all things by Him were made for Him. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? They would say that discussion was pretty much over. But that's amazing. Amen. How people believe that was His birthday. Amen. You have people all day, always arguing. We got some, they won't even celebrate Christmas. Because they say He was born in the spring of the year sometime, and everybody's doing it traditionally on December 25th. And we don't really know when He was born, so that's God. We ain't doing nothing. Hello. In Matthew chapter 2, there was a king named Herod. He didn't want to worship Jesus, he wanted to waste Jesus. But he told the Magi, the wise man, that he came far from the east to worship Jesus. Verses 2, somebody shouts, you don't matter how far you got to go. If you're really a worshiper, amen, you'll travel. Come on, somebody, you'll get there. Praise God, wherever you go. And they followed that star from the east and it held up, amen, over a house. According to Matthew 2, verse 11, this was probably around the time frame of 2 years after Jesus was actually born in a manger. Amen. Because now He is a child, according to Matthew 2 and 11. He's no longer a babe in a manger. He's a child in a house. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And they came to worship Him, and they stopped by Herod first to check in with him to find out maybe if he knew where this Messiah prophesied, this King of Kings is. And Herod pretended, Herod, who's a hypocrite, pretended that he wanted to worship Jesus, but really he wanted to kill Him. He wanted to waste Him. And he said, when you find out where this King is, this Christ child, come bring me word back so I can go worship Him. Around verses 7 or 8 of Matthew chapter 2. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So, but listen, Herod said in verses 8, he said, what time did you see this star? Yeah. And he made his decision from there that it had to be at least from that moment 2 years back. Yeah. That's why we say Jesus was probably somewhere around 2 years of age, because of what Herod said. Hello? Yeah. So Herod began to search it out from that moment about 2 years prior to that. This is the one I thought I took care of when I killed all those males. And come on, somebody. This is the one I thought, amen, glory to God, I would find when I sent my soldiers even to Bethlehem, and he escaped to Egypt. Praise God. But listen what happens here. Amen. Herod, amen, ain't concerned about worshiping Jesus. He's concerned about his wasting Jesus. And what does Herod, what's the spirit of Herod done? The spirit of Herod, all it wants to be, amen, associated with is what time? What's the date? Hallelujah. Listen here. I don't worship the day He came. I worship He did come. I worship Him. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost? Yeah. Spirit of Herod, spirit of the world, wants to talk about a date. Yeah. The Spirit of God wants to talk about the date with the Him who did come. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Hallelujah. And so those who are trying to saying when He's coming again, and those who are trying to debate about
When he came the first time or didn't come, they still operate out of the same spirit, the spirit of error. Come on, somebody. Somebody shout, Jesus' birthday is forever. He was the one, come on somebody, that stepped out into nowhere and with his spoken word said, let there be light. In Genesis chapter 1, verses 1, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Hallelujah, verse 2, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved on the faces of the water. Then by verses 3 and 4, God said, let there be light. And when he saw the light, he divided the light from the darkness. That's Genesis 1, 1 through 4. Somebody say in the beginning, God the Father created. Verse 2, ooh, I like him, son. Holy Ghost. It was dark. It was chaotic. The earth had no shape, no future, no hope, no form to it. Darkness was everywhere. Somebody shout, Holy Ghost likes the night shift.
Yes.
He likes that graveyard. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. He's a night mover. He's a dark mover. Darkness don't keep him from moving. Come on, somebody. Woo! I'll just shout right there. Go on, man. Praise God. Hallelujah. But then by verses 3, it said, God said, let there be light. So you find in the beginning, right in Genesis, Genesis 1, 1 through verses 4, you find God the Father creating, you find God the Holy Ghost moving, and you find God the Son, who is the God said, who is the light of the world. Come on, somebody, bring it to pass. Hallelujah. In creation, right there. And that's for those that don't believe in the doctrine that's triune and trinity. It's right there in the beginning of the book. Come on, somebody. And the Holy Ghost in verses 2 moved. Someone say he moved. God created. That's God the Father. God the Holy Ghost moved. And then God's Son. Because in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. John 1:1. Somebody say Jesus is the Word. See, 1 John 5 and 7 says there's three that bear record in heaven. The Father, the Word, the Holy Ghost. And by the way, that ain't a title, that's his name. These three are as one.
Yes.
Somebody say these three are as one. I'm going to say it again. These three are as one. I'm going to say it again. It's 1 John 5 and 7. These three are as one. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
I want you to know there's three that bear record in heaven. God the Father, God the Word, which is the Son, Jesus. Come on, somebody. And God the Holy Ghost. These three are as one.
Well, brother, I don't find the word Trinity in Scripture.
You don't find the word homosexual there either, but it's there. See, the Bible is a book. Come on, somebody. Of precepts.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Within the context. Come on, somebody. For example, you don't find the word homosexuality in there nowhere, but you can find in Leviticus 18 and 22, if a man lay with another man, like he would a woman, it's an abomination. That's Old Testament. New Testament, Romans chapter 1, verse 27. Men left the natural use of a woman, burned in their lust, not love, one for another, doing that which is unseemly, somebody say despicable, disgraceful,
yes.
Receiving even in themselves the recompense of the error of their way, which is meant, or meat, that was just. Having, so we find it's very clear, though it's not actually used, as far as that word, that terminology. You don't find Trinity, the word actually, there anywhere in Scripture, but the very concept within the context is very relevant. Come on, somebody. The precept is underlined even. I just quoted it. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, we're talking about Creator God. I don't know what I'm doing tonight. I'm just following the Holy Ghost. God's going to help somebody tonight. Praise God. I want you to know God didn't start off somewhere back in history. Amen. Glory to God in a manger. I want you to know He has always been. He said in Revelation 22 and 13, glory to God. Listen to what he said. He said, I'm Alpha Omega, beginning and end, first and last. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, He is Alpha. He is Omega. He's beginning and end. He's first and He's last. Isaiah 46 and 10 said He declares the end. preaching, I'm preaching the immensity of God. I pray I preach God so big and not your mind gets blown and you find faith in God again. I can't get you into faith in God until I blow your mind.